What's it going to take for the Detroit Lions to actually consider Darrell Bevell as the next head coach? Let's talk Lions. Thank you for liking, commenting, and subscribing to this channel. I appreciate it. Thank you for being here today. So my question for you is simple. What's it going to take for the Lions to actually consider Darrell Bevell as our next head coach? Is that something that they should even consider? All in all, I like Darrell Bevell. I like knowing that he was with a winning organization like Seattle. He was out in Seattle for a while. The guy knows what it's like to win. He wants to win. Now, it's tough because when you look at his run as the OC for the Detroit Lions, there's not a lot to write home about other than the fact that this year, our defense has been the problem, not our offense. That's a lot of what it's riding on him, and even the transition for him being our head coach is our offense hasn't been the problem. It has been the defense all year. Some of the things that I don't love about Bevell is his play calling earlier this season was very predictable. You sort of knew what was going to happen. You watch the boys line up and you're like, this ball's going to Hockenson, or this ball's going to Amendola, or and we're just going to run it because it's first down. We're going to hand it to AP and say, try it again, big boy. Like it became predictable. It's like when you watch the Pagemaster over and over again, and you know the boy's going to slip when he walks into the library and hit his head, and you're like, just stay home. You don't need to fix your tree fort. Not tonight. His offense became just overall predictable in a lot of areas. But again, offense wasn't the problem. So in order for Darrell Bevell to be considered for the head coaching job, I think it's very simple, very easy. He has to win all three of these next games. He just does. He has to win them very clearly, very definitively in order to have a shot. I think he's still going to apply for the position and be interviewed, at least be interviewed for the position no matter what. However, in order to be actually considered to be like, hey, you know what? Maybe this is the direction that we want to go in. Maybe this is the guy. He has to win all three of these games. And it's not going to be easy. Specifically going into this week against Tennessee, it's already going to be a tough game, and Matty Stafford may not be at the helm. So to win that game with Chase Daniel, come on now. I think if he beat Green Bay, Bevell's chances would have skyrocketed tremendously because he comes in his very first game and he defeats the Chicago Bears. Now, some people might look at that and they say that's not a lot to ride home about. For your first game in the NFL as the head coach of a sinking ship like the Detroit Lions and what Matty P lit on fire, I think it says a lot. I think it says a lot about him. And you look at the way he started play calling and the way he allowed Matt Stafford to huck the ball. Because Bevell now has the control of A, the offense, but B, the entirety of the team. And he put a lot of trust and a lot of faith in Stafford. And he played a totally different way than when he was the OC. As the OC, I think Bevell was playing much more conservatively. More conservatively than I would have liked to have seen. But as the head coach, Bevell has allowed the guys, the players, the Lions, to play at a capacity that's more carefree, more fun, more open. When I look at Bevell as the head coach, I am enjoying him more as our interim head coach than I was him as our offensive coordinator. If Bevell can win these three games, Tennessee, Tampa Bay, and Minnesota, then he goes 4-for-5. And if Bevell goes 4-for-5, I think that gives him a real shot as the head coach for the Detroit Lions. A, that tells me that the boys are playing for you. I mean, it just tells me that all the guys are behind you and that they want to see you succeed. You are instilling confidence and courage and everything that they need to win the game, and therefore they want to give that back to you. They're fighting for you. I think it's very evident that the Detroit Lions, that our boys are playing for Bevell. They won that Chicago game for Bevell, right? So to me, in order for Bevell to actually be considered for this job for the Lions, he has to win the next three games going 4-for-5. In order to be considered, I think, for a head coaching job in general next year, he has to win at least two of these games. If not, it sort of all gets chalked up to this, you guys went out there and they won two. You beat Chicago because it's Chicago, and then you beat Tampa Bay because Brady was old. All in all, I think Bevell does have a shot at the head coaching job for the Detroit Lions. And quite frankly, if he wins all three of these games, I want him to actually be considered for the position. Because then that tells me the boys are fighting for him, he's fighting for them, and all in all, we have a winning team on the up and up. Yeah, there's going to be a lot of weird stuff that goes on in this offseason with certain people getting cut, new OCs, maybe a new DC, because let's face it, our defense is atrocious. But all in all, I do think that Bevell has a shot at this job. What do you think? Drop your thoughts in the comments. A, what do you think it's going to take in order for him to be considered? And B, do you even want him to be considered for this job, or do you want to wipe your hands clean of every aspect of the Matt Patricia era and move on to somebody else? Drop your thoughts in the comments. I look forward to reading them, and I'll catch you next time on Let's Talk Lions.